Welcome back
to another video, guys. Today I am giving y'all a little girl talk, a little sit down. I feel like these videos, you know, aren't really put out there because I feel like some females are just really too scared to talk about like their bodies. But you know, I'm here, I'm open, I'm like super open, so I'm about to just be the mother to y'all and, you know, let you know some feminine tips that every girl should know. So sit back, grab your popcorn, grab your notebook, take notes, because today I'm going to teach y'all how to have the best healthy smelling vajayjay punani ever. Okay, y'all? Okay, so stay tuned, and if you like this video, do not hesitate to like, comment, subscribe, and share, and hit that red button down there to be part of the family, because we are the littest family on YouTube, Maya Gang or no gang. Let's get it, y'all. So the first thing I want to touch on with our feminine tips is about underwear, y'all. It is so much better for your overall, you know, health down there if you wear cotton underwear, because cotton underwear is breathable and air is gonna function through there, you know what I'm saying? We want it to breathe, because if something is trapped like all day, then there's gonna be smell and just excessive amounts of discharge, and we just don't want that. We want it to be able to breathe, you know what I'm saying? Everything down there needs to be circulating, flowing, all that, for it to be healthy. So cotton underwear is definitely the way to go. And I honestly don't even wear thongs that much, but I just stick with regular cotton underwear, and yeah, it works so much better for me. I definitely notice a difference between the cotton underwear and these kind of underwear that kind of have like a silkier outside that, like, if you were to get it wet, that it wouldn't dry. So definitely try to avoid these, because this is what traps everything in and doesn't allow it to all breathe and circulate down there. So you definitely want to try to avoid like the silkier kind of material and go for cotton. So this next one is gonna be like a little weird and like maybe a little surprising to some people, but it's honestly like a fact, and if you research about it, like, there's research to back this up, but sleeping with no underwear is honestly so beneficial for your overall health, and it actually boosts your confidence, guys, if you didn't know. So sleeping with no underwear really promotes good vaginal health, because you're finally allowing it to just breathe and be open. I honestly do recommend this, and it, seriously, guys, it boosts your confidence and it's overall just so good. So try sleeping with no underwear, and I'm telling you, like, you're gonna notice a difference. So next is cranberry pills. I use these cranberry extract pills from Spring Valley. I use one of these pills every single day, and I've been doing this for probably about a year now, and I have noticed a tremendous change in my overall vaginal health. And it also is a urinary tract health pill, so it's going to prevent urinary tract infections and promote just overall vaginal health. So I definitely recommend using a cranberry extract pill. You can get these at like Walgreens, Walmart, anywhere like that. So yeah, I love these. All right, so I've heard a lot of different opinions about this, but from my overall experience, I definitely recommend actually washing with an unscented soap down there. I'm not talking about the St. Ives, like, scented soaps. Those are just a no for me, but that's maybe just for me. I'm not sure for other people, but because that messes up my pH balance when I use like the St. Ives things. But I noticed when I use a just completely unscented soap from Dove and washing down there, when I mean down there, I don't actually wash the inside of the vagina, I just wash on the outside, and then I rinse it out really, really well. Everything's good down there. Like, there's no messing up my pH balance. It keeps everything really fresh and clean, because I hear some people say don't use any soap, and some people do use like a St. Ives soap. So it's really different for everyone, but in my opinion and from my experience, I would say just use an unscented soap and to rinse really, really, really well down there, because you have to remember that the vagina naturally cleans itself out. So when you put like perfumed soap down there, it's going to mess up your pH balance, and it's going to create maybe yeast infections and smells and discharge, and those are just so unnecessary, and we just don't need them right now, girl. So just try to wash with an unscented soap, or even just rinse really, really well with water, and maybe that would work for you too. All right, so another big thing is keeping it dry down there. So currently it's winter where I live, so I don't really have to deal with like the whole swimming situation. Some people who live in, you know, different climates and things, keeping it dry down there is so, so important. So making sure that whenever you're in a wet bathing suit, as soon as possible, you can take it off and just get it dry down there, because bacteria grows in wet, dry, dark places. So you might experience yeast infections and an odor and things like that. So I definitely recommend just trying to keep it dry down there. Like, as soon as you're done, just go ahead, dry yourself up and put on some clean cotton underwear, and you will be fine. Just try to avoid it being wet for a while. So another one, ladies, this one is super important because I feel like there's so many misconceptions about this, but it is okay to have like a scent down there. Like, ladies, we're not smelling like peaches and cream and like flowers. Like, that is just, that's not realistic, guys. I'm sorry, like, as much as we want it, like, it's not realistic. You're gonna have a natural odor, but when it starts to get, you know, a little funky and overpowering, that's maybe when you need to step back and be like, do I need to go to the gynecologist? Because that is not normal. But having a natural scent down there, like, that's, you know, it's not peaches and cream, baby. I'm sorry. I wish it was. I wish we all smelled like flowers, but that's just not, I'm sorry. It's just, no, it's not. I'm sorry. Yeah, just know the difference between having, you know, a little natural scent and just being a little overpowering. So you need to go to the gynecologist and see, maybe it's a yeast infection or what's going on, UTI. We don't know. But we don't want that. We're going to avoid that. That's why I'm giving you these tips. So just follow these tips and you won't even get there. I feel like this is one that everyone should know by now, but I'm just going to like reinstate it so we make sure that, you know, we've got it down packed. So there's no, you know, confusion about this, but always make sure you are wiping front to back, y'all. Please, y'all, do not wipe back to front. Like, you could just, please, no, do not wipe back to front. You're gonna bring so much bacteria from like your backside into your punani, and it's just, no, girl, just don't. Avoid it. You need to always, no matter what, no excuses, wipe front to back, because then you're gonna avoid all of that and just avoid so many infections. We don't want that. Just try to avoid it, guys. So next is one that I feel like every single person needs to know is, if you are sexually active, you should be getting checked for STDs if you have, you know, more than one partner. So guys, STDs are real. They're out there. You guys need to make sure you're protecting yourself. So make sure that you know that if you are switching your partner frequently, get yourself checked for STDs. Like, you don't know if you could have something, because some STDs do not even have symptoms, okay? So while you're over here messing with Johnny and Johnny's brother and Johnny's cousin, okay, and Johnny's brother's cousin had something, now look, now you got something and now you're stressed. You need to go and get checked, because you're not about to be carrying that around and then it's spreading and you don't even know it. So just don't. Save Johnny's cousin the mess and just go get yourself checked, okay? Just go. So number nine, I'm numbering these, okay? So number nine, my fact is, wash your underwear with unscented detergent, guys. So what I actually do is, when I take my underwear off at night, I go into the shower. But that's what Haitians do. Like, we grew up doing that. Like, you have to take your underwear into the shower and actually physically wash it with your hands. I understand not everybody does that because not everybody's Haitian. Not everybody has that, you know, privilege. No, let me stop. But that's what I personally do, and I wash it with unscented soap. But washing your underwear with unscented detergent is going to just eliminate any perfumes down there, because we want to avoid getting our pH balance off at all costs, because that's when all, you know, hell breaks loose. pH balance is messed up and it's over. So make sure you're trying to avoid that at all costs. No perfumes down there, no perfumed lotions, just no scents down there, because we want to keep it natural. We want to keep everything good, because again, the vagina cleans itself. It's very, you know, self-working down there. You know, it's very independent down there. It does what it needs to do. So just leave it alone, guys, and, you know, try to avoid the perfumes at all costs. Okay. And my last tip, my number 10, is to pee after you have intercourse. Okay. It is 2020. We're not getting UTIs, baby. Okay. So when you are done, you know, doing what you need to do, go ahead and go to that bathroom. You're not about to be laying down cuddling all cute. No, get up and go to the bathroom, because you need to pee, and that's that on that. Like, it's that simple. You need to go pee because we're not getting UTIs. So I definitely recommend go peeing. Guys, thank you so much for tuning into this video. I love making sit down talks like this. So if you guys do want more girl talks, more like feminine tips and things like that, go ahead and comment below and I will be sure to film for you guys. You know, I'm bringing you guys more videos than you've ever seen. Like, I'm just producing all this content. So go ahead and comment, and, you know, I'll read all the comments, so I'm gonna see. So again, thank you guys so much for tuning in, and I will see you guys next video.